In this video, I'm going to show you how to capture voice calls. In this example, I've got two IP phones using voice over IP or VoIP. We're going to capture the traffic from these phones and then replay it using Wireshark. Now, I'm going to show you multiple ways of doing this. In the first example, I'll use a network tap that allows me to tap traffic in the network. I'll also show you how to use Kali Linux and run a man-in-the-middle attack so that we can capture traffic between these two phones. Now, in this example, I'm using FreePBX running within a virtual machine on this laptop. So as you can see here, I'm running FreePBX within VMware, and I can connect to the IP address of the FreePBX server, 192.168.1.243, and I've got two telephone numbers configured, 1000 and 1001. So as an example, I could phone 1001 from that phone and a call is established. Testing, testing, testing. A call has been made between this phone and this phone. We can therefore successfully set up a call between these two phones, which have registered to FreePBX. Okay, so let's start with the first example using a network tap. In this example, the phones and the FreePBX server are connected to a Cisco switch. So you can see that they're all connected to the switch and the switch is providing power to the phones. The problem with trying to capture any kind of traffic from a switch is the switch doesn't forward the traffic out of all ports like a hub would. So in this example, we need a network tap or something to intercept the traffic. We could also use a span port or mirror port on the switch or use something as simple as a hub to see the traffic. So we need some kind of way to receive the traffic. As mentioned, I'll also show you how to run a man-in-the-middle attack using ARP poisoning on Kali Linux. But in this first example, I'm going to simply use Wireshark on Windows on this laptop. That laptop is connected to the network tap so that we can capture traffic. So as an example, if I run Wireshark on the laptop, we should be able to capture traffic. Now, the first thing we need to do is make sure that we capture traffic from the right interface. In my example, it's going to be Ethernet 5, which has no IP address at the moment. It's 169.254.72.40. So in other words, we're using a link local address. No IP version 4 address has been allocated on that interface. That's because the network tap is simply sending traffic to the monitor port. No traffic can be sent into the network so that that PC can get an IP address. So it's not going to be able to get an IP address from a DHCP server because the monitor port simply sends traffic out of that port, doesn't allow traffic to be received or sent from that port. So on Ethernet 5, we can capture traffic. I'll filter for IP version 4 traffic. So IP, we can see a bunch of traffic being sent into the network, TLS, whole bunch of other traffic. But what I'll simply do here is search for SIP or session initiation protocol. SIP is the protocol used between the phones and the PBX or private branch exchange, or in this example, free PBX for call setup, call teardown, etc. We're already seeing some messages from various devices. So in this example, we're seeing traffic between the server. FreePBX has an IP address of 192.168.1.243 and various phones. So we can see options and status information. Okay, so what I'll do is restart this capture. What I'll do now is set up a call between the phones again. Testing, testing, 1, 2, 3. Very exciting call between two phones. Okay, so call was set up between those two phones. We can see information here like ringing, trying, ringing, etc. There's an invite message to set up the call, etc. And then at the end, we have a buy message when the call is torn down. So just to make it clear about the setup, this is a free PBX server that's installed within VMware. It's a brand new installation. All I configured after downloading and installing FreePBX using the ISO is the extension numbers. So I've done nothing else except configure two extension numbers. The problem here is all that SIP information is in clear text, but the part that you're probably most interested in is RTP. So I'll filter for RTP here. You can see that the codec used is G711ULAW. Typically, that's the codec or encoding used in the US. ALAW is typically used in other parts of the world. But let's not get into the details of the protocol for the moment. This, however, tells us that it's a VoIP call. So if I go to telephony, RTP, RTP streams, I can see some streams. And I'll just select the first one and click play streams. And I'll click play call.
Testing, testing, 1, 2, 3. Very exciting call between two phones.
So it was as simple as that to replay the call made between these two phones. So just to make the point again, I'll restart the Wireshark capture and I'll save this as VoIP2 and let's do that again. So I'll make the call from 1000 to 1001 again. Here we go. RTP call. Hopefully we can capture this in Wireshark. Testing, testing, 1, 2, 3. Okay, so there you go. RTP is captured. Again, go to telephony, RTP, RTP streams. I'll select the first one, click play streams, and here we go.
RTP call. Hopefully we can capture this in Wireshark. Testing, testing, 1, 2, 3.
Now I could select all these streams and click play streams. And notice here I'm getting duplications.
RTP call. Hopefully we can capture this in Wireshark. Testing, testing, 1, 2, 3.
Okay, it was as simple as that to capture the traffic between two phones and replay it. FreePBX is not encrypting the calls by default. Once again, I have created a brand new installation of FreePBX by simply clicking download and downloading the ISO and installing FreePBX using the ISO. So on the downloads page, I downloaded the ISO. Same principle would apply if you installed Debian and then ran the installation script. Calls are not encrypted by default. You have to do extra configuration to encrypt the calls. All I did was install FreePBX, create these two extensions, get the phones to register to the PBX, and now I can capture the calls between these two phones. Now, not only can you capture RTP traffic, but you can actually see what's going on in the network. So I'll filter for SIP here. And what I'll do on this phone is ring 1001 again. Go off hook. You can see a bunch of SIP messages there. I'll kill the call. So we can see stuff like SIP invite, trying, invite, ringing, etc., etc. But it's much easier to go to telephony VoIP calls. We can see the calls between the devices. And then what we can do is look at the flow sequence. So here you can see 192.168.1.188, which is that phone over there, sending messages to 192.168.1.243, which is the PBX. You can see invite with codecs that are supported, G722, G711 ULAW, G711 ALAW, G729. We can see an unauthorized here and then ACK, and then we can see the invite again. And notice it says trying while it's trying to make the call to the other phone. Then it tells this phone that that phone is ringing. So we can see ringing. Then we can see the codecs that are supported, G711, ULAW, ALAW. There's an acknowledgement, call is set up. Then when the call is killed, we can see bye. So someone put the phone down and then we see an okay from the server. Going to the other phone, we can see something very similar. So we can look at the flow sequence and we can see the invite with the codecs that are supported. Notice the port 5060 is SIP. We can see that the phone is telling the server 192.168.1.243 that it's trying, that it's ringing. Codecs that are supported, acknowledgement by OK. So you can capture the entire call flow, call setup, call teardown, ringing, etc., as well as the RTP stream. So again, if I search here for RTP, we can see the RTP information and go to telephony, RTP, RTP streams. We could select multiple streams here and click play streams. And
you can see a bunch of SIP messages there.
So there you go. We were able to capture not just the RTP streams, but also the SIP messages. With a network tap like this, you can basically see everything. So you could look for other messages as well, like ARP, whatever other messages are taking place in the network. Okay, so now let's do it without a tap. So I'm going to remove the tap and I'm simply going to plug the Kali Linux machine into the switch. So all the devices are now connected to the switch. The tap is no longer used. So the problem with doing that is I can no longer capture the traffic. So I'll just make a call from this side to 1000. Testing, 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 1, 2, 3. Okay, so notice no RTP. If I look for SIP, no SIP traffic. The switch by default doesn't flood the traffic out of all ports like a hub. It simply sends it from one port to the other based on the MAC addresses that it's learnt from devices in the network. So this device is no longer going to see the traffic, but we're not going to let that stop us, because what we'll do now is run Kali Linux. Kali simply running as a VM on that laptop. So in Kali Linux, I'm going to search for etcap and run that. Need to put in a password. And what I'll do now is start etcap so that we can launch a ARP poisoning attack. First thing I'm going to do is discover hosts in the network. So we're going to scan for hosts. It's discovered 9 hosts. So if we go to our hosts file and look at hosts, we see various devices in our network. This is the IP address of the PBX. So if we had a look on our phones, we can see here that the IP address of this one is 121. So we could add that to target one as an example. IP address on this phone is 192.168.1.188. So we could add that to target two. So what we're going to do here is basically poison these two phones so that we can capture the traffic. So if we look at our targets, current targets, there are two targets. I'm going to click on this little world here and click ARP poisoning. So we're going to poison the ARP cache of those two devices. So we've got group one and group two. So previously we couldn't capture the VoIP traffic on this computer because we weren't using a tap, a network tap or something. But now, because we're poisoning the ARP cache, we should hopefully be able to capture the traffic. So I'll run Wireshark and start sniffing for traffic. We can see straight away some traffic here complaining about duplicate MAC addresses. So something's happening in the network. So what I'll do is search for SIP. And as you can see here, we've got some SIP messages. And let's search for RTP. So what I'll do again is make a call and I'll just hit redial. Hopefully Kali Linux can see this traffic. And there you go, you can actually see it happening on Kali. So the RTP traffic was captured because we're running an ARP poisoning attack. If I go to telephony, RTP, RTP streams. We can see streams here as an example. So I'll click play streams.
Hopefully, Kali Linux can see this traffic that you can actually hear that.
Okay, so not great quality, but we were able to capture the traffic. I mean, if I select all these streams and click play, we'll get some duplication, but you'll be able to hear the conversation. Okay, so not great quality, but it's possible to capture it, and then you could use AI perhaps to clean it up so that you can hear the actual voice conversation. Once again, we are running etcap on this laptop so that we can poison the ARP caches of these phones and see the traffic. And I was able to do that. Now, there are other ways that you could intercept the traffic. You could use a hub as an example. So get a hub between the phones, or in this example, between the PBX, and you could capture the traffic. But in the real world today, we're typically going to use a network tap like this. The problem with a hub is it only supports, say, 10, 100 megabits per second. But with network taps, you can do 1 gig or even 10 gig, depending on the network tap that you're using. In a previous video with my daughters, we explained the difference between a hub and a switch. And a lot of people ask the question, why would you use a hub in 2025? Well, here's a very simple example. I'm going to use a hub that will allow me to capture traffic between these two phones and replay the voice conversation. So a hub is like a cheap tap. Rather than buying a network tap like this, you could buy a cheap hub, which allows you to capture traffic. The problem is speed. It's only 10, 100 in a lot of cases. But if you wanted a cheap tap, a hub could do the job for you. Okay, so in this example, I'm going to run Wireshark on that Kali Linux machine so that we can capture the voice traffic and replay it. So I'm busy capturing traffic now. So what I'll do is search for RTP, and that will allow us to replay the voice conversation between these two phones. So on this phone as an example, I'll dial 1001. Phone rings here, and I'll answer the call. This is a call between two voice over IP phones. Can I capture the traffic using a hub? And I'll end the call. So that call has ended, but hopefully you can see here that a lot of traffic was captured. This is G711 PCMU, so ULAW. G711 ULAW is what's called a codec. It's basically the way that our voices are sent across a network using voice over IP. There are other codecs like G729, which I won't bore you with, but notice here, when I go to RTP streams, I could select one of these conversations and then click play streams. And notice I'll be able to play.
And I'll answer the call.
This is the call between two voice over IP phones, and I capture the traffic using a hub.
And I can replay that voice conversation. Now, in this example, I'm using Kali Linux in a VM, so it's not playing it necessarily very nicely. But the same principle applies if I was just using Windows on that laptop. So what I'll do is run Wireshark. I'll capture traffic and search for RTP. Nothing shown at the moment. So what I'll do on this phone is press redial, answer the call. This is the second call. As you can see there, my voice traffic is being captured. I'll end the call, go to telephony, RTP streams, and I'll press play streams.
This is the second call. As you can see there, my voice traffic is being captured.
So there you go. As simple as that, to capture traffic using a hub, I am basically using the hub as a network tap to capture voice traffic between these phones so that I can replay that voice traffic. Generally today, however, you'd use a network tap like this rather than a hub. But if you want like a cheap tap, a hub could do the job for you. Now, what's interesting with FreePBX is by default, the RTP streams go to the PBX. So if you intercept the traffic to the PBX, you'll see all the RTP streams, not just RTP streams between phones. So this becomes a major attack vector. This is the device that you want to attack because you can see all the RTP streams. By default, the streams are not encrypted. Again, all I did here was simply configure the PBX with two extensions, and then I got these phones to register with a PBX. I didn't do any other configuration, and I'm able to intercept the voice traffic. You're in the real world going to want to enable encryption of both SIP as well as RTP so that someone can't see what's going on. You could also span a port on the switch or mirror a port on the switch. So if you get access to the switch, you can simply mirror traffic. Most important device that you'd want to mirror is the PBX because all traffic gets sent to the PBX. So if you mirror the traffic from the PBX out of another port where you are capturing traffic, you can see everything that's sent to that PBX. Obviously, this would depend on the amount of traffic that's sent to the PBX. If you mirror everything, your port could be overwhelmed or your device could be overwhelmed. So you'd need a good sniffing device and a good device to capture the traffic. But it is possible to do that. Moral of the story is you can use ARP poisoning as an example to see the traffic. You can use a network tap. You could use a hub. You could use port mirroring. Let me know if you want to see any of those additional options. But hopefully you've learned something. If you did, please consider liking this video, subscribing to my YouTube channel, and clicking on the bell to get notifications. I'm David Bomble, and I want to wish you all the very best.